awesome friends, today we're going to learn how to make shadow art. So let's start first by getting our mantra ready because our mantra helps us be strong and focused for when we need to start our art. Remember, you can say it with me or you can always reverse if you don't remember how it starts and you want to just watch at the beginning. Here we go. My mantra, I am positive, I am creative, I am mindful, I am amazing, I am an artist. So shadow art. Here's the thing. You might be able to find shadows if it's kind of a sunny day, but there's other days where you can't find shadows. Can you make shadows? Absolutely. So find a light and then put some things kind of positioned in front of the light so that it can give you this really cool shadow. So basically all you need to do is find a space where the shadows on a tabletop or on a floor are making some sort of interesting design. So let's get started. I have found a really awesome shadow. It's actually from a plant and a little cactus, and I'm just laying my paper, a white paper, down in front of my shadow. So of course you can create whatever kind of shadow you'd like. Maybe you're gonna have somebody hold a shadow for you with their body and make some sort of motion. But I really like the organic shape of these shadows. So what you'll do first is actually just trace around the outside and find the open spaces. We call those the negative spaces in between the shadows. So the shadows are the positive spaces and the open spaces are negative. So now we're just gonna fill our paper with a little bit of open negative. Once you've traced all your shadows, now it's time to color. Remember, the awesome thing about art is you can use any tools that you want. So if you have any markers lying around, if you want to use paint, if you want to use colored pencils, whatever you might have around you, and even if it's just the pencil, you can use your pencil to make really cool patterns and designs or just shade with value by having a hard pressure in one spot and then lighten the pressure from there. So I'm going to just go crazy and use any tools that I have around me to start coloring in the actual negative spaces and leave the background positive. But again, it's your artwork. You can really change it and make it however you'd like. Let's get started. Added color to all of your negative spaces, you might want to do a little tracing over your pencil with a black Sharpie or something that might make it a little bit more bold, and then decide how you want to add some color and details to your background. Maybe you're just going to color and add patterns. I'm going to choose to paint because I think it will be a nice way to fill my whole paper. But again, you pick whatever materials are closest to you that you'd like to try to use to fill your space. About this shadow art is that you kind of can't ever really end or make a mistake. I think I might go back into it and add some patterns or maybe use it for some collage later down the line. So hang on to your shadow art and see what you can do to be really creative and use it for something else or decide when it's finished. Now that we're done, we're going to do a little bit of mindful meditation at the end just to refocus ourselves and make ourselves have a really awesome day. So what I want you to do is put that hand right on your chest, hand right on your belly, on your diaphragm, and really focus on making sure you're taking a deep breath from your belly, not from your chest. It takes practice. It's hard for me too. So here we go. Breathe in. Breathe out. And I want you to close your eyes and imagine a safe space. It can be somewhere that exists, like somewhere in your home or somewhere special to you, or it can be somewhere that you make up in your head. But imagine that safe space. And keep breathing and think about what colors are around you, what the smells are around you, what the sounds are around you, and focus on making that safe space somewhere you can always come back to in your head. That safe space is not going anywhere, so breathe in and breathe out. And use that safe space to come back to whenever you need just a moment to recenter. So I want you to think to yourself and remember, you are amazing, you are strong, you are resilient, and I love you. We'll see you next time.